What's going on? This is the Captain's Log, comedian Joe List. What's up, buddy?
Not too much.
This is your first appearance.
I know, this is terrible. By the way, this is like a great camera shot. We're pulling back, so like it's like the background is changing. happy to be here. This is exciting.
Thanks, man.
I've never done anything in a car before.
This is your first.
Sex, yeah.
A lot of sex in the car?
I wouldn't say a lot, but you know,
keep it real.
Twice, aunt was a spicy lady.
not in the marriage though, I bet. That's probably not car sex material.
No, we don't even have a car, so we'd have to rent a car.
Which, or sex.
Yeah, I have to rent the sex also. Alright, I'm trying to find myself.
Pop up here in a minute so we can share it. We're live with Joe List. He's gonna be at Off the Hook. Go ahead. He's probably live now. And it's gonna be all weekend. Thursday, which is tonight. There's gonna be a show at 7 and 7 and 9 all weekend, all the way through Sunday.
I can't wait.
It's going to be a good time. And this is your second time here, but my goodness, you were a rookie when you came last.
Yeah, well, I mean, I was a veteran, but I've been doing comedy so long. I started comedy when I was 9 years old. I'm 30 years in here.
That's what were you telling, Jack and Jill jokes?
Yeah, it was Jack and Jill have sex in a car. I was here in summer, maybe May of 2009. I was opening for Nick DiPaolo, and that was when the club was in Marco Island, or on Marco Island, whatever you say.
Right.
And we stayed at like a resort. I don't know if you remember.
You did.
You put us in this crazy resort.
It was a good deal.
It was unbelievable. I mean,
you should have paid me for that.
It was pretty unbelievable. It was like the nicest place. I still have photos somewhere on Facebook, I think.
They redid that resort, and they spent like $100 million to make it even better.
Oh, wow.
It's crazy. I know. That's now it's a JW Marriott. Before it was the Marco Island Marriott. And they say it's one of the busiest Marriotts in the world. They stay like 99% occupied year round.
No shit.
And enough about them, because they don't sponsor this show. Yeah. The hell with them.
No, I hope they all die.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
I shouldn't say that. This is going out live. I can't even like edit this.
We are live.
Oh, jeez. I don't hope anyone dies. I want everyone to be great and fine.
Did you get to share it?
I did. I'm shared.
This you is are shared. Shared.
So what does that mean? I don't even know what that means.
That means that your people right now, if they're on there watching, which they will be, and maybe they're, you know, scrolling through, they can say hi. If you guys are watching, tell us hello, what city you're in. I'll even give you tickets to tonight's show. Can I give them some tickets?
Yeah, please. This is going to be depressing, though, if no one writes, hey, I'm a fan of Joe.
You never know. I mean, they could be watching on their phone at work, and they don't want to get busted.
So I hope so, yeah.
They just sneak peeks. But yeah, I mean, like 180,000 people a week watch.
Wow.
Between all the shows. I'm on every day.
180,000?
Yeah, so that's good.
Yeah, that's great.
And it's been steady, so we're having fun.
I'm happy to be here. I'm hope I don't have. I hope I get those kind of numbers.
You brought your wife.
I did. My wife is here. Come on out, Sarah.
No, she's not here now.
No, she's at home sleeping. She's in the hotel sleeping. Yeah. Yes.
Do you have any kids?
She came along. No kids.
No kids.
Sex. No kids. Oh my God.
Wow, that guy just blew his air horn. Yeah, Ace is the place. The helpful place. And apparently he's helping that guy put his car in gear.
Yeah, look up from his text. But yeah, my wife is here. She's in bed right now. But yeah, she's hilarious. I don't think she's ever been here either, to Naples.
No, this is her first?
First time, yeah. We do Key West every year. But this is our first time.
So there is a club down in Key West, right?
It's not a club. I guess it's a club. My friend would be mad if he heard me say that. It's a bar show, but they're kind of making it a club.
Yeah, but it's only been going for a couple years, right?
Yeah, a little bit.
Because they actually contacted me, and I said I wasn't going to do it.
Oh, really?
It's too much for me.
Yeah, it's a lot. I mean, it's a strange place. Yeah. It's hard to get to. It's a weird island. But it's a fun place. You can walk around naked. They have...
Yeah, like the Garden of Eden. Did you go up there?
Garden of Eden. I've been there a few times. Well, last time...
Did you pull out the whole junk?
When I went years ago, in my drinking day, I don't drink anymore. I'm old and I'm gay now. But
you know Gary DeSilva? He's in Billerica, Mass.
I know Gary DeSilva.
What's up, buddy? Yeah.
Gary's a firefighter. I've known Gary for 20 years.
Well, we're giving you a little shout out right there. Put out all those good fires and be safe, Gary.
Yeah, Gary, come down to Naples right now, immediately. We got a show tonight.
Yeah, support the show. Buy a ticket, he said.
I hope that's the right Gary. That would be bad if it was...
Now, Gary DeSilva, it's your boy.
Yeah, that is my boy.
He loves you.
That's nice. That's who I get. I don't get fans. I just get people I grew up with. But anyway, I don't even know what I was saying now.
Me neither. Do you have ADD? Because I do.
Well, I think we all do now with the phones.
Is
Forget about it.
The phone keeping you busy?
It's all I do. I look at the phone and that's it.
And you forget it. Like, what's going on?
A lot of times. I've gotten better, but I think I'm better than most. When I'm with people, I'm great. When I'm by myself on the road, I do a lot of looking at the phone. It's a situation.
I do too. And when I look at the phone, though, sometimes I can't hear anybody else. Just the phone.
Oh, yeah. Totally. You're immersed.
Right?
But it's the whole world. Part of me, some of it's great. You can learn. Like, a lot of times, I'm not just looking, scrolling through social media. I'm reading shit.
I do the same thing. I hate reading novels, but I'm definitely learning, like, what's going on in the world or what's trending.
Yeah, yeah. You know,
what's trending on Instagram.
Yeah, you're obviously very
That's
sad.
That's very important.
That's important stuff. No, I read. I do well. I'll read. But this is what I do now. Now I'll watch a movie. And like 3 minutes in, I'm like, I'm going to look up the director. I'm going to find out where the director grew up. And then I'm like, I can't even watch the movie. I keep pausing. I'm like, let me see if she's ever been naked in anything.
What about the documentaries? Those kill me. Because I'm like, now I got to Google what's going on with this guy's life before it ends.
Right, right.
And I'm in the middle. I'm like, I already know this guy's, you know, made it or it's a bust.
Right. By the way, this guy just wrote in that I was saying I was old and gay. Now I remember we were talking about Key West. about going to Garden of Eden. And yeah. I used to get naked there. But now, in sobriety and older age, yeah. I don't get so naked.
And you can't bring out your phone at the Garden of Eden, right? They don't
yeah,
let you.
No,
right
no,
away,
so.
they get on top of you for that.
But you
it's
think,
frowned upon.
When I first went there, I was like so excited because I was 23 or 24. And I was like, I'm going to go see some naked people. But
yeah.
The people that get naked at Garden of Eden are
it's
125 years old.
It's not the same caliber.
Yeah, it's not like yeah. beautiful women walking around topless.
Right.
You're going to see an old pud.
Now, there is some naked resorts across the world, like in Ibiza and stuff, where there's some very attractive naked people.
That
but the Garden
nice.
Of Eden seems to attract not the finest, not tens.
Yeah, no.
It could be some good sevens.
It's not a hot spot. I think maybe you get a visitor or something like that, but
right.
I think it's also... ends up being mostly dudes that think they're going to go see
a bunch of naked woman. Chicks.
So you got like 11 naked guys and a few people and
yeah.
their pants going, this sucks.
Right.
I
never did that. I never went to the Garden of Eden, but I know it well because I've been to Key West, and who doesn't hear about the Garden of Eden?
It's pretty cool.
It is.
I spent some time in Key West. I do now. I go there every year to do this show, but when I was young, my friend Tom Dustin, who runs the show,
yeah,
we went down there and had a wild... time. I mean, we got robbed by two women in Miami the day before we went. We
get
lost
out
all
of
our
here.
Cash. Yeah, I had $1,000 in cash taken.
No,
from
a
me.
Lady robbed you?
Yeah, well, what happened was, I guess they were kind of like ladies of the night. I thought I was just killing it.
Yeah, you thought you were hooking up with these chicks.
Yes, exactly. So we were walking around drunk.
I gotta hear this.
And I was the only guy, I'm wearing like jeans and sneakers.
Yeah.
I'm wearing like New Balance sneakers walking up South Beach in Miami.
Right.
Which is like the hippest place on earth.
Yeah,
you know?
And you looked... like an easy target because they're like, these guys are on vacation.
Yeah, I look like a goof. I had like, you know, wired glasses and Sears jeans from Sears and everything, all Sears head to toe. And so
what year was this?
This was 06.
Okay.
So I was 24 and this woman walked up to me and she was hammered and she was like, hey baby, you want to part? And I was like, yeah, let's rip it. I just got here.
Right.
I'm from Boston and let's have some fun. She's like, well, where are you staying? I was like, I'm staying right over here. And it was two women. They were kind of heavy, but I was, you know.
Yeah, you can't ask for the best on the road. You take what you get.
Yeah, I was into it. And they came up to me. I mean, they
right.
Sparked it. So I was like, yeah, let's go to my room. And then I was like, I got to find my buddy Tom. And they were like, no, he's with our friend. So I just thought these three random women just started grabbing
right.
us. And I find out
you
later.
You thought you were hot shit. Like,
yes.
I am freaking handsome in South Beach.
Yeah, so they walked me. I mean, again, these were not... attractive women, but
right.
They were very nice. They were like, they took me by the arm, you know, I was
yeah.
elbow and elbow. I had a girl on each side, which is a dream.
Sure.
Went back to the hotel, and then one of them started, we can be dirty on here, right?
Yeah, to a point, sure.
Okay.
Kind of censor it.
I don't want to get too crazy, but she took her bosoms out.
Yes, she took out her boobies.
Yeah, and she was pressing them on my face and kind of doing one of these things. And then the other girl, I was like, well, where are you at? What's going on here?
Yeah.
And she was kind of touching my genital area over the pants.
Yeah.
And I was like, this is amazing. What a wild. I'm having a threesome in Key West. I just got here. I mean, in Miami.
Yeah.
I just got here an hour ago. And then all of a sudden, she was like, you know what? We're going to get out of here. And I was like, what?
Wait.
I was like, I'm not even naked yet. What are you talking about? Yeah. And they were like, we got to go. It was great to meet you. And then they just took off. And I was so drunk that I was like, boy, that was weird. I was like, maybe I said something.
Yeah.
And then I looked over and I could see the zipper of my bag was open. And I had all cash. I didn't have an ATM card at the time.
How did they know to go right to the bag?
I think one of
them. Were you like, yo, I got bags?
No, I think she was just rifling through the bag.
While the other one was taking, was
yeah, she was kind of like
smothering you with the breast.
Yeah, exactly.
So and you like, were breast smothered. That was like her bird cage, the bird box.
Yeah, classic.
She bird box you.
Yes, exactly. Classic move, a breast smother.
Yeah.
Because you can get away with anything if you can smother someone's
absolutely
face with the breast.
No doubt.
So she did that, and then the other one, I think, had like one hand. She was kind of touching me, so I knew she was there, and then with the other hand was going through my bag. And again, I'm like,
how did they know to go through the bag and not your pockets? They're good.
They might have gone through the pockets also.
It was probably an hour. But it was an hour of breast smuggling.
They probably were like, this guy doesn't have an ATM card. This guy's a loser. I don't know.
Okay.
But they went through and I just had cash. And like my mother before I left was like, you shouldn't carry cash like that.
Yeah.
But I just didn't have a bank card. I just had cash. So I lost $1,000. And then my friend showed up. Oh, that's what I forgot to say. So in the middle of it, my buddy Tom showed up.
Yeah.
And I was like, dude, look at this. This what? Is crazy. Because I didn't realize I was been robbed yet. And he was like, I just got robbed. He's like, I lost $500. The whole thing.
They had already hit him up.
Yeah, yeah.
So they literally told you, oh, my other friend is taking care
yes
of your buddy.
So it turned out he was receiving a style of sex, you know.
Right.
And they were going through his pockets while doing that. So he at least received like some more sexual, he was a little bit more advanced sexually
right
than I got. I just got a booby smother.
Yeah, and you were excited about that.
I was thrilled with that. I mean, at the time, you know, I wasn't exactly crushing it, nor am I now, by the way.
When you're married.
I mean, I have a beautiful wife, of course. But, so anyways, that was that. And then, so it was day one of like a 7-day vacation, and we lost 100% of our money. I had to call my mother, my aunt wired us some money.
Oh my god.
And I had to pay her back. And
that's like the thing where you get the call and it's fake, right? Hey, I'm on vacation. I lost all my money. Can you wire me money?
Yeah, it seemed like a joke. And like the day before she was like, this is a bad idea. And I was like, yep, we got robbed. I mean, day one. But the nice thing was we went down to Key West and we started telling everyone the story. It's a great atmosphere,
yeah, it's a
down
good,
there.
Yeah.
And people would buy us drinks and stuff. People were like, oh, that's terrible. Let me get you a beer. And we kind of milked it quite a bit. We got a lot of free booze. And we would just tell the story together. People loved it. We were a big hit down there.
I bet.
But yeah, it was great. But for years, I'm finally doing well enough that I don't add that $1,000 to my like account when I look at my money.
Right.
For years, every time I looked at my statement, I'd be like,
I wish
this
I had
$1,000 more.
Yeah.
But I also gave like this great big like Rudy speech where I was like, you know what, who gives a shit, they need to take our money, let them take our money,
right,
we're not gonna let this stop. It was like this
yeah
big like rah-rah
yeah
speech.
You felt you were feeling it right from the heart.
Yeah, we
and
had
the
to,
wallet.
Yeah, exactly. We had to keep it going. We ended up having like the time of our lives. I got great photos of all of it.
So my buddy owns Irish Kevin's. Did you get to go to Irish Kevin's?
Yeah, I've been to Irish
yeah
Kevin's.
Yeah, that's
yeah
Irish Kevin. That's my buddy.
No kidding.
Yeah, so he's a good time.
Yeah,
that's how he's the one that contacted me and said, my friend's opening up a bar and going to do comedy there. I want you to book it. And then I was like, I can't.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So that's how I was like contacted. Wow, that guy just threw that thing right
yeah
there.
I think he just dumped a bottle of urine out the window, which is fine, you know.
So, so tell me, you grew up in Boston.
Yeah, well, Massachusetts, South Shore. I grew up in Whitman, Massachusetts.
Okay, and I grew up in Wakefield.
Yeah, which is I feel like similar towns, but flipped.
Right.
The one's north, one's south.
Yeah, one's north, one's south.
Which, by the way, we call it Massachusetts. I never thought this was weird. We always say South Shore, the South Shore Plaza, but it's not the shore. I grew up like 35 minutes from the beach.
Yeah.
Like the South Shore Plaza.
Yeah, we say North Shore.
Yeah, it's in Braintree, but it's like we're not on the water.
Right, we're not on the shore.
Yeah, so
like
people,
shipwrecked.
Yeah, people would be like, people would come visit or whatever and see where I grew up, and they're like, so where's the beach? And I'm like, the beach. And I'm like, the beach
that's
is like
funny
40 minutes away.
So do you have the roast beef sandwiches like Bill and Bob's? Is that a thing on the South Shore? I know it's huge on the North Shore.
No, well, there's Mike's Roast Beef was a big... I moved to Everett for a couple of years.
Okay.
For comedy.
So in Everett, so you had like...
it was Kelly's. Was
Kelly's.
Not and, far. And then
right
Mike's Roast Beef, which is still there. I still go up
it's
there.
It's delicious, right?
Yeah, it's
there's
great.
Nothing like that around here.
No, it was amazing. I mean, someone should come down here and do a roast beef place.
I did.
You made a roast beef?
Yeah, place? I did in 2005. Captain Brien's seafood and roast beef. And I did the exact thing.
And it didn't...
It did really well. It turned into Captain Brien's, then it turned into Off the Hook Comedy Club.
Oh, wow, okay.
But that's how I started. And Bill and Bob, the owner, came down. He says, I heard you're the Bill and Bob's from the down south. Oh, I'm going to see your roast beef. And he cooked roast beef in my kitchen.
No shit.
And he taught me, like, the secrets.
Wow.
The real freaking thing.
Oh, I thought I had a million-dollar idea, by the way.
No.
You've already done it.
Yeah, I did it. I did a lot.
Wow.
Some worked, some didn't.
That's the way it goes.
That's how you roll.
It's like jokes. Wow, that's a good...
You got to test out the waters.
Yeah, exactly.
Randy wants me to say, I want to hear a chicken finger. I like to say chicken fingers. Do you say chicken finger or chicken finger?
Well, I'm hanging out with you, so I'll start sounding like that again.
Yeah.
Like when I go home to hang out with my family, I'll start sounding a little more like a Kennedy.
Yeah.
To me, when I was drinking, or if I get really angry, my accent will come out a little bit. But
my parents have lived down here for 22 years, and so have I. But my accent's mostly gone, I think.
Right.
Or is it bad?
I don't think it's bad at all.
Okay.
I noticed
but my parents sound like they literally have never left.
Right, right.
I'm like, how do you still talk like that? Nobody else is doing that.
It's interesting because it's so ingrained. That's just like how you speak, I guess. But it was weird because when I was a kid, I got made fun of because I would say bathroom.
Yeah.
And like everyone made fun of me. They're like, what are you, an English piece of shit, whatever? And then I was like, oh, all right. So I stopped saying bathroom consciously. And then, like, Good Will Hunting came out, and it became, like, the coolest thing to sound like
that. Yeah, Boston.
So all of a sudden, like, I was like, I had this, like, accent, and people would make fun of me. And I was like, oh, God, I guess I'm a nerd. I sound like I'm British. And so I changed the way I talk, and then Good Will Hunting came out, and all of a sudden, like, everyone in my class was like, go, you wicked crazy. And I was like, you didn't sound like that 2 days ago.
And everyone said, like, wicked, I didn't realize wicked wasn't a thing.
I didn't either. It's amazing how many things you realize. Like, Patriots Day is not a holiday anymore.
People correct.
Are like, what the hell is
what
this?
What is Patriots Day?
Yeah, I thought that was mind-blowing to me. Because I still go up there every year for
Patriots
Day.
And Columbus Day is, like, I think that people don't get it unless you're up there. What do you think?
Columbus Day?
Yeah.
That's a national holiday, isn't it?
Yeah, it seems like it, right? And they want to tell you about Plymouth Rock.
Right. Yeah, Plymouth Rock they love, and that's a fascinating... But, wait, Columbus didn't land on Plymouth Rock.
No, who did?
The Pilgrims. Yeah.
So that's why we get Patriots Day, or no?
No, Patriots Day is about, I think, Battle of Bunker Hill. Bunker Hill Day. Patriots Day is...
Hill Monument.
Some sort of revolution. But that's not actually on Bunker Hill. That's actually Breed's Hill. And Bunker Hill is in, like, Somerville.
This is true.
That's some
trivia. That is a good little knack that you've acquired along the way.
Yeah, a little Boston trivia. By the way, are we going somewhere? I feel like you're just flipping around.
I don't know what the hell's going on. Drive and drive until the conversation gets dead.
Okay.
And once the conversation dies, I pull in.
I get nervous. Every once in a while, I look over, I'm like, where the hell are we?
No, there's no turn in. There's no access to get in here. So you got to go down, turn right, left, and pull in.
Well, Patriots Day is a holiday in Boston. I still go every year because the Red Sox play at 11:05 a.m. and the marathon's going
on. That's right.
I go every year.
Which is the best. That's a huge day in Boston.
It's the best. You go to the game and then you spill out in time to watch all the, you know, kind of the not elite runners.
I go to Pizzeria Regina. I get some pizza on the way in.
Yeah, you can do that. I do. I mean,
I love it.
We live it up. I mean, I love it. I go every year. This past year, the game got rained out, which was frustrating. I was there for the bombing, which was... That's not a fun thing to bring up on a comedy show.
But it's very interesting.
Did you see
the movie?
I did not see the movie.
You didn't?
I saw the real life thing. No,
wow.
I did not see the movie. I should see the movie.
The movie's great.
I'm sure I would enjoy
it. It's really interesting.
Yeah. That was a fascinating time.
Unbelievable. Well, anyway... Guys, this is the Captain's Log. Joe List, go see him at Off the Hook Comedy Club tonight through Sunday, telling the ha-has, all the jokes. You're going to love him. You see him on Netflix. Now you see him on the Captain's Log. Joe, thanks, buddy.
Thanks for having
me. Let's go. We're going
it.
On radio station now, 103.9, then 96 K-Rock. We just finished 105.5 The Beat. We're out, and the Captain's Log will be live tomorrow. Two episodes, so I know you get so excited. See ya.